What's up, y'all? I said, what's up, y'all? Look at me when I'm talking to you, bro.
Nah, I'm just messing with y'all, man. This is Knockout Boxing 86 TV, and we in here. So check this out, bro. Before I get going on today's video, y'all should know what to do by now, bro. Be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new here, and share the video, bro. If you come through and watch the video, be sure to hit the like button, put your seatbelt on when you hop in my car, and also comment down below. I want to chop it up with y'all and talk boxing with you, but I can't do it unless you leave a comment, so be sure to comment down below so we can chop it up and talk boxing. And if you want to have me hop on a panel or you want to collaborate with me, reach out to me on my email address at knockoutboxing86@yahoo.com. Again, that's knockoutboxing, the number 8, the number 6, at yahoo.com. But without further ado, let's get it popping and get into today's video. And today, we're talking about Errol Spence and Manny Pacquiao, bro. This video is going to be a follow-up from the video that I made yesterday. Yesterday, we dropped a video on why Manny Pacquiao beats Errol Spence. Some reasons why Manny Pacquiao, if he were to be successful and beat Errol Spence, I gave y'all some reasons why I think that might happen. And in this video, we're doing just the opposite, bro. This video is why Errol Spence will beat Manny Pacquiao. I'm going to break down some of the things that I think we'll be looking for that if Errol Spence does successfully, he'll probably end up beating Manny Pacquiao. So here we go, bro. Here we go. I got five categories that I'm going to talk to y'all about. It's really seven. I had to group some shit together because I don't want y'all looking at a 30-minute video, bro. Y'all will stop my shit halfway through. So I want to make sure I get through everything. So some of this stuff will be grouped together. But here we go, bro. Let's break it down. So first reason, bro, jab and body work. Those are two separate categories, but I'm putting them together, bro. It'll be because of his jab and his body work. Errol Spence has one of the most underrated jabs in boxing, bro. He showed how good his jab was against Danny Garcia. Errol Spence, if he's winning the fight, that means he's controlling Manny Pacquiao's distance with his jab, catching him, you know, consistently, coming in, trying to get out with his jab that he has, and also following up that jab with great body work. We all know Manny Pacquiao, or any fighter for that matter, if you work their body long enough, they will break down, they will slow down, and the jab and the body, the jab, number one, is going to slow Manny Pacquiao down from just jumping in, and then the body work will add to that by slowing his feet down and his hands down even more. So if Errol Spence is being successful in the fight, I believe it's going to be because his jab is working. He's controlling the pace and he's controlling the distance with his jab, and he's getting to Manny Pacquiao's body and slowing him down. That's the first reason. Another reason I could see him being successful and why he would win the fight if he were to be successful is the strength of Errol Spence, bro. We all know that Errol Spence in this fight, between this Danny Garcia fight and this fight with Manny Pacquiao, he's been a lot more disciplined than he had been in recent years. You know, he was partying, ballooning up in weight, you know, having to have, you know, self-admitted fat camps and trying to get in better shape. He doesn't have to do that this time, bro. He's already in shape. He's hired his strength and conditioning coach, Blu-ray, back, who Blu-ray was the one that helped Errol Spence show, look like a damn G.I. Joe commando, and when he was knocking everybody out and went on that long knockout streak that he had. He's back with him, bro. So expect Errol Spence's strength, if he's successful, to play a huge, huge role in this fight. Errol Spence, undisciplined, will already come into the ring stronger than Manny Pacquiao. He's just a bigger, stronger guy, and that's just going to be something that, you know, Manny Pacquiao really can't do much about. Now, coming in disciplined and already in shape and having a camp where you're focusing on your skill and you got your strength and conditioning coach, who you were very successful with in prior years, that's going to probably do some good for Errol Spence. And again, if he's successful, it's because his physical strength is going to show. That means he's pushing Manny Pacquiao around, pushing him back, you know, really, really punishing him in clinches, ragdolling him, and just, you know, bullying him, bro. And that strength is going to be the key if he's successful in this fight. Another thing, bro, is just the activity and the pressure of Errol Spence. I don't think Manny Pacquiao has fought a fighter like Errol Spence that's going to apply that tactical pressure. And what I mean by that, you hear people use that term loosely. What I mean by that, bro, is Errol Spence, there's no wasted movement, bro. There's no wasted movement. He's stepping to cut you off every time. You know, where you go, he goes. Just like a mirror, bro. And coming behind that jab, using that body work, bro, and his activity, he punches a lot. He don't slow down throughout a fight. You may see him take a break every now and then. I think in round like 9 or 10 against Danny Garcia, he might have took a break, bro. But he got stronger as the fight went on. And his activity don't really slow down. That's one of his strengths, bro. His punch rating, his output, and his cardio, bro, he be right there. He be right there the whole time. And if Manny Pacquiao can't handle that activity and that pressure, it's not going to bode well for him, bro. It's not going to bode well for him. So that'll be another thing that you'll need to look for. If Errol Spence is very active, and he's cutting off the ring and applying that pressure to Manny Pacquiao, and he's constantly in his chest, bro, and he's pumping out that jab and then getting in with that jab and then working the body of Manny Pacquiao, that activity and that pressure along with the strength of Errol Spence, bro, it can be very, very bad for Manny Pacquiao, bro, if Errol Spence was to win this fight. And if you notice, all the things that we're talking about, they go hand to hand, because how do you apply your strength by getting inside? What's the best way to get inside? Coming up behind your jab. That's what Errol Spence is probably going to be trying to do, coming forward behind his jab. What's the best way to slow somebody down that has faster feet than you, that has faster hands than you? Going to the body. Errol Spence works the body. If you strong and you disciplined and you got your strength and conditioning coach, What's the best way to apply that? Trusting in your cardio, knowing that you ain't gonna slow down. Continue that high level of activity, continuing to apply that pressure. So as you can see, the reasons that we're doing, bro, they all go hand in hand as to why if he's successful, I believe this is the things that we'll be looking for. We'll be like, okay, yeah, damn, bro, he jabbed the shit out of Manny Pacquiao tonight. Damn, bro, he was working Manny Pacquiao's body. Shit, bro, he was just stronger and bigger than Manny Pacquiao. Damn, bro, Manny Pacquiao kept getting pushed back. He couldn't handle the pressure. He couldn't handle the activity that Errol Spence was bringing. So those are our first three. Those are our first three that we're talking about, bro, and that's some things that you'll need to look for. If Errol Spence is winning, it'll probably be for these reasons, bro, a few of them, if not all of them. The other thing, bro, that we want to talk about, bro, the youth of Errol Spence, bro. The youth. He's going to be more than 10 years younger than Manny Pacquiao. So as we said, you know, in yesterday's video, if the 2 years off does Manny Pacquiao justice, we'll be seeing that if Manny Pacquiao is successful. Now, if he's unsuccessful, and Spence is the one that looks like he's just better, he's just more vibrant of an athlete, he's just, you know, a step quicker, bro, then it's going to be because of youth, bro. It's going to be because age caught up to Manny Pacquiao at the wrong time, bro. It's because we're going to be able to see very clearly, very early on in that fight, oh, shit, Errol Spence is the more athletic. He's a stronger athlete, bro. Manny Pacquiao look rusty. Manny Pacquiao look old. Is he already gassed out? Like, the youth of Errol Spence, bro, is going to play a huge part if he ends up being successful in this fight. And that's our fourth reason, bro. So far, we got the jab and the body work. We got the activity and the pressure of Errol Spence. We got the strength of Errol Spence. The youth of how young he is, bro, having that age advantage. Manny Pacquiao aging overnight. You know what I'm saying? And I wouldn't say overnight because it's been 2 years since he's been in the ring. Bro, that's a long-ass layoff. There's a difference between 40 and being 42, bro. Trust me. I'm 35 now, bro. Between being 33 and 35, bro, my knees be crackling. Before I go run every day, I got to stretch and shit now. I didn't used to have to stretch. You know what I'm saying? So I can only imagine between being 40 and being 42. And these are professional athletes, bro. I'm just a dude trying to stay in shape so I can be around for my kids. And hopefully one day when my kids have their kids, I can be around for my grandkids and be in shape and not need a walker and shit, bro. Imagine a professional athlete, dog. Imagine a professional athlete that's boxed his whole life. And now all of a sudden you take 2 years, excuse me, 2 years off. Shit, the youth could play a huge, huge part in this fight. And that's going to be a key. If Manny Pacquiao is not the same fighter, bro, then the youth of Errol Spence is going to play a huge part, and that's something that we're going to be looking for in this fight as well. Last but not least, is I believe if Errol Spence is successful, we are all going to look back. We are all going to say, if he's able to win this fight, we're going to say the same shit that we were saying after the Mikey Garcia fight, bro. And that is this. Damn, bro. The fans, Manny Pacquiao, Freddie Roach, all the fighters that picked Manny Pacquiao, all of them, bro. All of us, if you're one of the ones that's going to pick him. I ain't saying who I'm picking yet, but everybody that picks Manny Pacquiao, if Errol Spence were to win this fight, they going to look back and say this thing for sure, in my opinion. Damn, bro, we underestimated his skill level, and we underestimated his athleticism. Because, see, that's what everybody is saying, bro. Oh, Manny Pacquiao is faster. Oh, his feet are faster. Even I think his feet are faster. You feel what I'm saying? So I ain't just talking about other people. Manny Pacquiao's feet are faster. You know what I'm saying? Manny Pacquiao, he got faster hands. If we look back here and we see Errol Spence countering Manny Pacquiao, timing his ass, cutting off the ring relatively easy, showing great agility and agile movement to where Manny Pacquiao is constantly cornered in the fight, we gonna all look back and we gonna say, damn, bro, we underestimated his athleticism. If we see you know, Spence throwing that jab, throwing that right hand, then a combination down to the body, weaving out of Manny Pacquiao's punches and shit, showing great defense, parrying his shit, and then countering him like he was countering Danny Garcia. We're going to be looking back like, damn, bro, we underestimated his skill, bro. Shit, I knew he was good. I knew he could be special, but he just did that shit to Manny Pacquiao, bro. He just did that shit to Manny Pacquiao, dog. So, if he's successful, bro, those are the main reasons why, bro. And I gave y'all five of them, man. And I'll recap it for y'all and let it go. Watch out for his jab and his body work. The jab will keep Manny Pacquiao at bay and keep him from just going in. And the body work is going to slow Manny Pacquiao's ass down earlier than usual. Because we all know Manny Pacquiao is a fast starter. One or two good body shots in the first two rounds, that's all it take, bro. It don't take a lot of body work if you hit them in the right spots, bro. Dudes can slow down, bro. They can get broke down pretty quick. And Manny Pacquiao ain't been the best at taking body punches. He don't really like that shit like that. You feel me? So jab body work, that was the first reason. Second reason, the strength of Errol Spence. If he just throwing Manny Pacquiao around, if he just pushing him back easily, bro, and Manny Pacquiao can't do shit, that strength is going to play a huge part. The activity and pressure. We all know what Errol Spence's style is. You know, he did something a little different than the Mikey Garcia fight. But even in that fight, bro, when he started beating him up, bro, he pushed him, bro, he right in his jaw, bro. He right there in his jaw. He going to be right there for Manny Pacquiao. He ain't running. Ain't no hiding. He ain't finna just be on the back foot, you know, trying to ollie shuffle. Errol Spence coming right there to the center of the ring, and he bringing the shit to your front door. He'll take steps back and counter and box and shit, but for the most part, he going to be right there. So the activity and the pressure of Errol Spence is going to play a huge part in determining whether or not he's going to be successful. And then the youth of Errol Spence. He's the younger man. Manny Pacquiao been out the ring for 2 years. You feel what I'm saying? He going to be 42 years old. Does age catch up with Manny Pacquiao at the right time? Or at the wrong time if you're a Manny Pacquiao fan? You feel what I'm saying? Does age catch up with him at the wrong time? If it does, then we're going to say that the youth of Errol Spence had a huge part in determining the outcome of this fight. And then the last one, people going to have to admit and people going to realize that if Errol Spence wins his fight and he shows what he's capable of showing, people going to be like, damn, we underestimated his skill. Damn, his feet are faster than I thought they were. Damn, his hands are quicker than I thought they were. He was beating Manny to the punch. Shit, and then his defense, I didn't know his defense was that good. He weaved some of Manny's shit and caught him with a counter. He was parrying his shit, bro, like, and then countering him with a left. And then going down, like, damn, bro, I didn't know he was that skilled or that athletic. I knew he was athletic, but shit, I thought it would be a difference. But it wasn't really no difference between his athleticism and Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao's hands wasn't that much faster than Errol. You see what I'm saying? Like, so that'll be the thing, bro. Like, people will look back and be, damn, we underestimated him, bro. But all in all, man, it's going to be a great fight. So there you have it, the two videos, man. Go check out the one yesterday on why Manny Pacquiao wins, how he's going to win, and if he wins, what to look for. And then on this one right here, bro, these are some things you should look for. If you see Errol Spence winning a fight, or after Errol Spence wins a fight, I believe wholeheartedly you'll be able to point back to one, if not all of these things I just mentioned, bro, to be like, okay, yeah, that's what Knockout was talking about, bro. That's why Errol Spence ended up winning this fight, bro. But all in all, man, I enjoyed doing this for y'all. We're going to continue to cover this fight, man. I'm thinking of different ways I want to cover it, what I want to talk about. But we're going to keep covering it, man. It's a huge fight. I'm excited for it. Can't wait to see it. But y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Same question from yesterday, but for the other fighter, man. If Errol Spence wins this fight, how do y'all think he's going to do it, man? What do y'all think some keys are going to be for him to be successful in this fight? Let me know down in my comment section, man. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, share the video, put your seatbelt on when you hop in my car. If you come through and watch it, be sure to hit that like button. And also, hit me up if you want me on a panel or you want to collaborate. KnockoutBoxing86@yahoo.com is the email. I appreciate everybody that's watching today. Y'all enjoy the rest of your day. And with that, we out. Chill. Peace.